What key innovations will EREMA be showcasing at K 2025?
Today we have here the Pre-K event exclusive for the journalists from Europe to introduce our new technologies from the different application, in-house recycling, post-consumer recycling, chemical recycling, bottle recycling to the market with a lot of new technology that we will bring on the K-Show to our customer, to the market. It's a pleasure for us to give this upfront information to the journalists in detailed discussion and quite valuable, fruitful discussion. And I hope we will see on the K-Show, on the EREMA booth, that you personally get also the news from EREMA for your recycling business. Please have in mind that also on the outside area, there is the EREMA and Lindner booth together to show live recycling of washing and extrusion, and all of you are invited to the K-Show, to Düsseldorf, to the EREMA booth to get a feeling about our news in this joint adventure in the different application. Thanks for coming and visiting us on the K-Show.
What are your latest developments in chemical recycling?
Chemical recycling, always a topic for hot discussions and very exciting discussions. So also today we had those for EREMA. It has been a couple of very interesting months where we have delivered the first large machines and started up the first large machines into chemical recycling. One of those machines being a CHEMAREMA 2325. The largest extruder we have so far sold into the direction of polyolefin recycling. Apart from that, we will be preparing for the next K-Show. Our next size for the CHEMAREMA 2628 is the dimension, featuring a 280 millimeter screw, and this will allow melt preparation for chemical recycling reactors up to 4.5 tons. But apart from this, we have today for the first time presented the AGGLOREMA. It's our first machine that is able to prepare difficult to handle, very contaminated moist feedstocks directly into agglomerates, into compacted materials, which allows again for the chemical recycling market easy and low cost transportation, but then also safe and clean operations in the plant. And this together with the CHEMAREMA we see as a perfect package for the chemical recycling customer.
How is EREMA supporting digital transformation in the plastics industry?
We here at EREMA have two possibilities. We have on the one side RE360, what is a special tool what we create directly at the customer, what is on-site, or we have Blueport. Blueport is a plug-and-play service with a very easy license model behind, and a lot of users are already online. I would estimate around 3,000 of end customers are using Blueport already, and all of our network is using it as well. Blueport is a plug-and-play service. It means all our machines are equipped with the technical devices you need. You simply put it on the internet, and then you can consume a lot of information directly at your mobile device, if you like, or on a desktop version.
Does Blueport also include older machines?
We here at EREMA do think that we should also go into the past, because we have a lot of customers who are trusting us since many, many years. All machines since we were founded in 1983 are inside of Blueport. And all information what was digitally available after 1994, I mean the whole history of spare parts we have delivered, is as well available online. So we are even going into the past. If you like to have, for example, a machine what you have bought 20 years ago, with all these IoT devices as well, you can even have an upgrade. An upgrade is available out of the year, let's say 2004 approximately. So more than 20 years.
Which applications are most used by your customers?
The most important modules what people are using, it comes from the historical past. In 2019, we have done the IoT side, and in 2016 we have at the K Show launched Spare Parts Online. Spare Parts Online is for sure the most used app because a lot of people do need spare parts and are buying online directly from us. But even the other apps like a documentation or a maintenance app, for example, they are very, very helpful for our customers, and I would mention these apps.
What's next for Blueport in the near future?
We have a plan for the next 3 years what we want to create as further services. For example, I can tell already, because it's not a secret anymore, we will have remote assistance as well directly on Blueport. That means that you can go on the HMI of your machine directly in the Blueport window without any barrier. And this will be one of the next things, and furthermore, what are more or less secret. We do as well have some different methods to measure how healthy our machines are. We call it the predict-on series. For the predict-on series, we have different devices. First of all, predict-on drive, and we have predict-on plastification unit as well. Plastification unit, for example, is a new tool where we measure the wear of the cylinder and of the screw. And it helps to tell the network if the machine has any problems and if our technicians should travel there, for example.
What are your highlights for post-consumer polyolefin recycling?
This year, innovation for post-consumer recycling for the K-Show from EREMA will be, on one hand, our EREMA TV Plus Duafil compact machine. We will have the first time in a large size, the so-called 2021 size. It's a 212 millimeter screw and a 2000 millimeter preconditioning unit in one piece, so we do not need a cascade version anymore. That means the machine will be more compact, less maintenance, as you have only one motor, one gearbox, and less energy consumption at melt temperature, as we do not need a melt pipe between the two extruders, as it is one piece. We will have several highlights for food grade recycling in polyolefins. So our way in the past with FDA for outside of Europe, we will follow up with the novel technology. So several projects for all important material streams are already in the project phase or already submitted to the European Commission. That's a big highlight and will drive the way forward for the circular economy and for the PPWR to get 10% PCR into sensitive packaging. On the non-food secondary packagings, for example, it needs these high-quality recyclates to get this 30% PCR at least in the products. Goal is always 100%, of course. And we will also show innovation, a combination of preconditioning unit with a twin screw, the so-called Twin Pro machine, which gives the industry the possibility to feed to the machine light bulk density material. As the packaging gets thinner and thinner, it will get harder to feed it to the recycling plant. The PCU preconditioning unit is perfect for that. With the countercurrent system, we can handle 20 grams per liter up to 800 grams per liter, very flexible. And with the twin screw, we will get more homogenization. That means on one hand, it's for in-house recycling very important, for films like PEPA or PE with EVOH, to homogenize the material really well, to get more PCR content in the products, on the production side already. On the other hand, it can help also a lot in the post-consumer recycling for PP rigids coming from packaging, 3D packaging, which is very thin. That's so far our highlights for this upcoming K-Show. Some more highlights will follow at the show itself.
Tell us more about the joint venture between EREMA and Lindner.
1.5 years ago, the companies Lindner and EREMA have decided to make a joint venture with Lindner Washtech, where it's involved.
And what is the key and what was the reason behind? We want to bring the complete recycling process into a complete chain. So that means we want to bring qualities, we want to improve quality, and this is the only way that we are take a look of the complete chain. So that starts with sorting, goes over washing line, and then also with the extrusion process.
What are the main benefits of this joint approach?
What we have shown today and what we always want to present on the K-Show is what are the benefits, with this joint venture. Optimized processes between washing line and a recycling extruder, and also the benefits in terms of energy efficiency, digitalization and automatization. I think here is still a lot of potential in these processes to fit together. That it's not only two separate units, it must be one unit together, and this we want to show really strong on the K-Show this year. So what we have exactly prepared is, once is energy efficiency. So there are a lot of potential to use energy from the recycling extruder back into the washing line process. And this we have worked out. So we want to use, for example, the energy from the granulation process back into the thermal drying unit. This we have worked out. Then also one HMI dashboard where we are presenting or where we are showing critical parameters that makes for the operator much more easier, and that the process works more in line together. So when we have stoppages or problems changes on the filter system, that we can slow down the complete process automatically. And when issues on the shredder are solved, that we can increase then the capacities. And it gives a huge potential for the customer. It's completely automatically, and also in terms of energy, low downtimes. It's also for these recycling companies extremely important. And this we will show on the K-Show.